Good morning, everyone. In the previous lesson, we introduced turning operations, and it was a preliminary dive into the subject. But today, we are going to enter into the specifics of turning technology. In our initial lessons, we will start by getting to know and understand the tools better. As we continue the course, we will tackle all the technical characteristics of the materials they are made of and their applications. And finally, we will learn how to properly define the technological parameters in order that we use them in the correct machining conditions. The information that awaits us is truly interesting and crucial for a turner. So Paolo should now get going without wasting any more time. I am Fabrizio, he is Paolo, and this is, of course, CNC of course. As we said in the introduction, a good turner must be familiar with tools, both in terms of application and nomenclature. What, Paolo? Why? Let's pretend you're a plumber. Paolo, where are you going? You don't have to wear a helmet. A plumber doesn't wear a helmet. You're already making a bad impression, I'm warning you. In fact, I'll put you to the test. Pass me the parrot. No, Paolo, no. That's not the parrot. I thought so. What kind of professional do you think you are? Here, let's avoid doing it also as operators and turners. That's why today, we are going to define the nomenclature of the tools and precisely the insert applied to the tool. Most turning tools are mechanically fixed, therefore composed of a shank and an insert mounted on it by various methods, screw-on, rigid, or with a lever clamp. And although the ISO standard always struggles a little to keep up with technology, all builders and users have adapted to the nomenclature defined by the International Standard for Turning Tools, especially ISO 1832 for the insert, ISO 6261 for tools with cylindrical shanks, and ISO 5608 for tools with square shanks. In this course, we will only deal with the insert nomenclature, which is the formal designation that a turner should know. In fact, once the insert is correctly defined, it will be easy to find the shank by consulting the catalog of the various tool builders. Let's start by saying that the standard method identifies inserts with a series of letters and numbers, which, depending on their position, have a precise meaning. These 12 parameters are used to uniquely define our insert. Of these 12 parameters, the first 7 will always be present, while parameters 8, 9, and 10 are additional and identify the characteristics only for certain types of inserts. Finally, the 12th parameter is for the builder and is usually used to identify the chip breaker geometry. The first parameter defines the shape, and this is where we start. Let's take a look at what is probably the most widely sold and used insert in the world, and which many machine shop operators know by its code, CNMG 120408. The first parameter is a letter, in this case C, and identifies the shape of the insert. C, for example, is a rhomboidal insert with an angle of 80 degrees between the cutting edges. Let's see them one by one. R stands for round. It identifies a round insert. S stands for square. It identifies a square insert. L is a rectangular insert. C, as we said before, is a rhomboidal insert with an angle of 80 degrees. W is also a rhomboidal insert with an angle between the cutting edges of 80 degrees and is very similar in its use to its shape. We will deal specifically with the differences in additional info. This is followed by another rhomboidal shape, but in this case with an angle of 75 degrees. Then the triangular T insert with an angle of 60 degrees. Then a trapezoidal one, again at 55 degrees. And finally, the last two rhomboidal ones, D and V, which have an angle of 55 degrees and 35 degrees. Some of these shapes, and specifically L, K, and E, are rarely used, and often missing in the catalog of many builders. Coming back to the shapes, we can see that the main difference is the angle between the cutting edges. It is a fundamental characteristic that identifies two important and opposite features. the strength of the cutting edge, and its versatility on the geometry of the piece. In fact, putting the inserts in order from right to left, we can say that on the left the inserts are stronger because they have greater angles between the cutting edges compared to those on the right. Where on the right, thanks to the angle between the lower cutting edges, they have a greater capacity to perform different profiles. The insert with a larger angle will be, as we have said, more robust than a smaller one, and therefore more suitable for heavy-duty operations such as roughing a workpiece. Combined with a tool having a certain side-cutting edge angle, it will handle certain difficult operations better, especially on materials that are difficult to work on. Vice versa, smaller angles and inserts with a certain side-cutting edge angle will be recommended for lighter machining operations, such as finishing, or will be used where profiles require penetrations at very wide angles. For specific applications of the various shapes, please refer to additional info. Let's take our CNMG 120408 insert and analyze the meaning of the second letter, which in this case is the letter N. Let's make one thing clear right away, N does not stand for negative. This is a myth that you sometimes hear in the workshop. N means that the insert clearance angle is zero. This is the angle formed between the side of the insert and the perpendicular to the face of the insert. So, an insert clearance angle of zero corresponds to 90 degrees between the face and the side, which allows us to say that the angle of zero makes us have an insert that could be used on both sides, in which case it is called a bilateral insert. Before going on with the clearance angle, let's share a final thought on the N rake insert. With the zero angle, the most common system for clamping the insert to the tool is the lever type. This system is not only one of the most widely used, but also one of the strongest, despite the fact that the insert in most cases has a perfectly cylindrical central hole into which the tool lever is inserted to ensure a correct assembly. Once the insert is manually placed in the tool slot, it is mounted and secured by a screw with an Allen key head, which pulls the lever into place, allowing the insert to be mounted. Don't use excessive clamping force. It will do harm. We could damage the system if we apply an excessive tightening torque, because it could wear out the tool components that form, build, and allow the insert to clamp perfectly. Let's now take a look at the other clearance angles. After the zero angle with letter N, the most commonly used angle is C, which has a clearance angle of 7 degrees. The letter C assumes that it is a screw clamping fixing type. The screw fastening is not as robust as the lever fastening, because this time the inserts are laterally sharpened and single-sided, so they can only be used on one side, which is the main side. Tools of this type are suitable for finishing, profiling on sliding headstock, bar, or multi-spindle machines. Having a 7-degree side clearance for the insert may mean it is less robust, but despite this, there may be inserts with even greater clearance angle, P with 11-degree clearance, and F with 25 degrees. Paolo, why is there such a wide range of clearance? Very good, Paolo, for internal machining. I think you beat me. You are very good. They are made this way because the inserts have to be mounted on very small diameter tools, or because the cutting edges need to have a special sharpness for machining aluminum. In fact, because of their simple and slim construction, these inserts and tools are generally used in internal turning operations, where the diameters of the holes to be machined are smaller. These tools are commonly called boring bars. Another example where an insert with a clearance angle greater than zero is used is where inserts are mounted onto positive tools, a subject we will deal with in a separate lesson. Let's resume the coding of our example insert. We have arrived at the third letter, the letter M. This letter represents the tolerance class of the insert. All inserts, as well as all mechanical parts, have tolerances. But the insert tolerances are given on the circle within the figure. Okay, Paolo, let's explain it better. I got it. Let's try to visualize the shape of an insert. Each shape is pretty much a geometrical figure. We have just seen a rhombus insert, a square one, and a triangular one. Well, inside each figure, we can draw a circle that, according to the size of the insert, will have a specific diameter. And it is precisely on the diameter of the circle that ISO uses the letter M to establish the tolerance class. Specifically, the letter M indicates a medium tolerance, in the sense that this range of values is not about precision, but completely something else. Of course, there are more precise tolerance classes identified by letters such as G or E. We will use inserts with precise tolerance classes when we need to guarantee we can repeat the positioning of the insert on the tool, and therefore have a greater certainty on the maintenance of dimensional tolerances, even after replacing the insert. Here, the advantage of not having to set the tool again will have to be properly evaluated, considering the increase in the cost of the insert itself. With the letter G, we conclude our group of letters. This letter identifies the type of tool. For example, it clarifies whether the insert is double-sided and has a geometry, namely a chip breaker. If, instead of the letter G, we had the letter A, we would have a double-sided insert without geometry, so with a flat face, typical of those machining cast iron. As we all know, cast iron does not need to break and control chips, since this type of material does not produce classic metal chips. In both cases, however, the inserts would need to be clamped with a lever clamping system. In the case of inserts where the second letter is C, typical of screw clamping, at the last place of the group of letters, we would not have a G or A, but letters such as T or W. In the first case, it would mean a single-sided insert with a chip breaker. In the second case, a single-sided insert without geometry. Therefore, like the previous flat face insert, also screw mounted. Paolo, how are you? Wait, do you already want some coffee? Are you tired? No, come on. Anyway, for today it's fine because the lesson is over. So, we completed the first part dedicated to the letters. But be careful, we will have to take it up again later. Where are you going? No sleeping. Come on, come back here. Don't be lazy. Also, start taking notes because things need to be taken in little by little. Otherwise, you will only be confused. Especially for someone like you who is always thinking about something else. And I know what it is. Maybe it's better if I don't say it. Let's forget about it. Let's see each other in the next lesson. Always here on CNC, of course.